Okay, let's check another way to submit our farm data. So see, in a previous video we have an error when we checking the uniqueness of the name in a company, and if which we are checking that the if the sorry in a validation rule, so name of the company should be unique and the uniqueness with the currently logged in user and who has created that company, also the currently user should be matched with the user ID in a company's table. So if I make it clear to you, so user ID this one, so if it is in a company's table also check the currently logged in user ID with the user ID in company's table, this field also check, and also check the name of the company. So two field it will check, the name of the company and the user ID of the currently logged in user. If both the fields are matched, so it will show the uniqueness. If it match, it will show the error, the company already exists, and whose the company is that user. So the currently logged in user, if it is also matched, so it's also that user has also created that company. So it makes an error when I show you the error. So let's refresh. And it says that parse error, syntax error, unexpected comma. So it shows the comma that we have encountered in last video. And just we have this field comma here, and we have to remove this one. Save it and let's refresh the page. So it is clear now, there is no error. Okay. So the one way is to validate this function is to by validating using the method of validate. And you can validate the request. So when we progress and you follow along with me and throughout the application, so we will not use this validate method, because we have to validate all the fields, suppose the same field throughout many methods. So we have to create the method in this validate method in every. Suppose if I am creating and I have to validate this in store, and if I am updating the company, so I have to create the same line of code in our new update method. So that's a bad practice, and we will use another way. So which is the other way? To create a request. So let's minimize it and come to our app HTTP controller. So under the controller, so there is no request directory yet. And I will create a request, so we will validate all our requests in one file, and we will get you throughout the application. So let's jump to our terminal. So cmd, and here in we are terminal, clear screen, come to our directory cd xamp htdocs. Htdocs and smart expense, and I want to show you the directory that it will create. Write this HTTP. Okay, PHP route, and let's check PHP artisan, and let's check the method for request. To create a request, where it is? Make, it will be under make request. So here, so create a new farm request class. We can create a farm request class. Okay. Clear screen, PHP, artisan, make request, and the request name will be create company request, and it will create a you see a directory request, and in the directory request we have now create company request. So it has created the file class for create company request, and it will extend the, all the form request. So it will, we can use all the functionality from a form request. So we will make a public function authorize. So we will return true. So only authenticated user can access this class. So save it. And here we can define our rule that we have used in our controller. So the same rule that we will use, and copy that rule. Copy it and come to our request. So paste it. So name required unique from company's name and also the user ID. So save it. Let's check our application if there is no error. So it's okay, fine. Okay, so now we can, how we can inject this request to our controller, company's controller. So now we are injecting a request, so we will not require inject the request. We will say create company request. So this one, create company request. So inject this, and we need not to include this validate function. Okay, right now I am commenting this, and let's remove this one. So let's comment this one, whole code, and we will use a very simple way to create a company. Okay, so it will, this request will validate the form. We are not required to validate more. Okay, let's instantiate our company model. So we will kept in a company variable, and we are instantiating company, and remember that we have included that company model into our company's controller. So company, and we will say that request variable, and we will use a method all, that all the method request that comes in that variable, so it's kept in this company model. So we will not singularly, we have to give a name, a field name with email, password, and any field. So that how many fields that you are putting through your form will be get and will kept this in company model. So company variable. And we have to now give the auth currently logged in user, and we have to give companies. So company, you will be confused at this stage. I am stopping it and not doing to this, because let me include the relationship, because this will use the Laravel relationing. Okay, let's come to our create a relation in our user model. User model. So we will say public function companies. A user can has many companies. So simply, user can create many companies. And we will use this method, and we will say return. So return the model, which is this has many relation. So the user has many companies, so we will use the relation has many, and we will tell it. So if you can get that model, so app, and we have a company model. So let's copy this function, and so in our company model, we will save it. Where we have created this function? I think we have done it wrongly. Not in this file, because it's a user detail. We required a user. In our user. So public function companies, and a user has many companies. We will return, we are returning this method. So return this has many, this model, company model. And in a company model, so we will say, a public function user. So this company belongs to this user, and we use return this, not has many. So we say belongs to this user model. So this company belongs to this user model, and a user has many company. So one to many relation. See company. Okay. Now we are done, and we can simply access this method that we have created in our controller, and we say currently auth user, and user model has a company's method. So we can say a user model, so user function will get to go to a user model, and we can say now you can get the method of companies, and companies. So and when you get the companies method, so it will get the relation and save what to save, that we have a variable company. So all the fields that we are getting from request, we are kept in our variable company, and we are now getting this variable to save into our companies method, which is in a user. The user has many companies, it will save in user. So remember that here we have, when we commented, we have to find the user ID. So here we have not to give the user ID, because it will automatically add the user ID into companies table. Okay, save it, and only we have to return when the action is performed. So we can return the user. So return, redirect back with the message new company created. So save it, and let me check if there is no mistake. So we have done it. Let's check create an other company. Refresh the page, and let's refresh the database table companies. Okay. And we will create a company, Afan Tech. So hit submit. So app HTTP controller create company. So there is a mistake. REQUEST does not exist. So we have to include this request. So here we have not included this request that we have created. here is the create company request. So let me, I am using a PHP companion. So if I go to, so here create company request is included. So let me remove this. So save it, and you can see when I enter F5, it will automatically include this file. So you can check my the Sublime Text series for all the packages that I am using right here. So you can find that solution. So save it. Okay, we have included the request. Come to your browser. Come to back and refresh the page. So create a fan tech. Sorry, tech. And hit enter. So class app actually requests auth not found. Why it is not found? We have included the auth. Auth user companies. Save company. Class app HTTP request. So it is saying where it is not found, class app HTTP request. And Smart Expense app HTTP request, create company request. So in the company request, we are using facade auth. So we have to include this also in the request. Let's quickly include this. And I'm using the same PHP companion package. So let's use Illuminate facades. So save it, and let's come to our browser, come back, refresh, and let's add, and let's check in our database. It is refresh it, so it's not great. Okay, create a fan tech, and what, okay, let's check. So again, undefined variable company, where auth user, save company, lots of error. So where is the undefined company? When I check it, it's not matching. So where is the problem? Typing error. Company, save it. Come to our browser. So refresh one more time and create a fan tech. Submit. So congratulations. So we have now created a new company through a different way. And let's refresh our database. So a fontech is now created. So it's all now depend on you, how you can create this method. I think this method is a very simple, quick, short and smart coding. So less coding as compared to this method. So stay tuned and take care.